Hello friends, welcome back to my channel BM Tutorials. In this video, we will discuss about classification of fluidized bed boiler. Fluidized bed boilers can be categorized into two main groups depending on the mode of operation of the fluidized bed. These are as follows. Fluidized bed boiler can be classified as follows. First one is atmospheric fluidized bed boilers. This also classified in two categories. First one is atmospheric bubbling bed boilers and second one is atmospheric circulating bed boilers. Also fluidized bed boiler classified into pressurized fluidized bed boilers, atmospheric fluidized bed boilers. Fluidized bed combustion FBC is ideally suited to the burning of solid fuels or low calorific value waste. In the FBC system, fuel is added to a fire bed composed of inert particles such as sand or limestone. If sulfur capture is required, which is fluidized by blowing combustion air upward through it. This produces highly efficient combustion and allows the use of low-grade fuels that are not suitable for conventional combustion plant designs. Operational efficiencies for ABC are 25 to 35%. Similar to conventional coal-fired plant, the atmospheric fluidized bed combustion systems run close to atmospheric pressure. There are two types of ABC boiler. First is bubbling fluidized bed combustion, BFBC, where combustion is in a conventional bubbling bed and combustion efficiencies of 90 to 98% are achieved. And second one is circulating fluidized bed combustion, CFBC, where the bed medium is entertained and circulated with the combustion gases. A cyclone separates the bed material and returns it to the main chamber. CFBC can achieve combustion efficiency greater than 98%. Atmospheric fluidized bed boiler. Typical fuels for AFBC are coal, anthracite, petroleum coke, oil sale, biomass, shredded tires, paper sludge, wood waste, high sulfur solid fuels, municipal sludge, and industrial process waste. The ash is used as a cement aggregate or for other construction materials. It is generally inert and non-hazardous. Although testing may be performed to detect any possible hazardous residues. Application of FBC boilers for power generation with low grade fuel. This is an ideal technology with numerous advantages stated before. Old boilers can be converted into FBC or retrofitting is easily possible. Pressurized fluidized bed boilers. In a PFBC boiler, improvements in the design of FBC technology have been made to reach higher operating efficiencies by using differential air pressure, special bed geometry, etc., aiming to improve the combustion of difficult materials such as high sulfur solid fuels and biomass. Operating efficiencies for PFBC are 33 to 42%, depending on fuel characteristic, ideally sulfur content, ash content, and calorific value. Type of PBFC system, ideally combined cycle versus turbocharged, circulating versus bubbling, and peak temperature of the gas turbine. Second generation units, which integrate gas and steam turbines, are expected to have efficiencies in the range of 45 to 50%. The space required for repowering a conventional coal-fired power plant with ARBC technology would be similar to that required for a flue gas scrubber unit. Conventional particulate removal from a ARBC is by cyclone, baghouse, and/or electrostatic precipitator. Solid waste from ARBC containing fuel ash, calcium sulfate, and consumed solvent can be safely used for landfill or sold as a by-product. Electrode boilers will describe in detail in next video. So friends, if you like this video, then like and share. Also, don't forget to subscribe this channel and press bell icon for getting notification of my upcoming videos.